relationships and conversation, but how do those spaces not recenter, re-perpetuate some type of, you know, space that revalidates a white supremacist or white-centered culture in a way. And I saw that happen a lot with my work over the years in Palestine solidarity work, where I saw a lot of Jewish anti-Zionist spaces, you know, unintentionally recenter Jewishness and often European ancestry Jewishness, Ashkenazi Jewishness, whatever you want to call it, in spaces of you know, talking about Palestine solidarity. So it's a complex thing, it's something to keep grappling with. But at the same time, I think another simultaneous conversation to have is this question of what is the role of white people who are part of communities that are majority black, majority brown, majority indigenous, and other people of color communities to be in those communities in the way that that is useful, helpful, and does not perpetuate that white supremacist culture that ends up keep resurfacing its ugly head. You know what I'm saying? So that's my two cents on it. But it's an ongoing question and contradiction is always emerging.
This one, I've been thinking a lot about this as of late, as I've shifted from the solidarity framework to the co-liberation framework. And the reason why I've shifted from that framework is because I need for people that I consider allies to look at this, the white supremacist system, as a hindrance to their well-being as well. So I'm not looking for people to be able to opt in and out of that structure. I need for people that I'm in that I'm allied with to understand that none of us are benefiting from this system. And even in a framework of privilege, it's destroying your humanity, if anything. And so we have a friend named Sterling who says who has a quote where he says, privilege can be debilitating because it minimizes your ability to realize your full potential. And so, you know, if you're being tied to this system on a deeper level is somehow a privileged or perceived as a privileged position, then you're in trouble. You know, you're in trouble, which is why when Shay talked about the leading causes of death right now is because the system is crumbling and dying. And honestly, the people who are closest to that system are going to suffer the most because the people who are quote unquote on the bottom have been working on survival techniques from day one. And so I think that as we reimagine our humanities, we have to recognize that our liberation is tied to each other, and that there is no hierarchy in this, in being tied to the system. It's a fucked up system, and we all need to be trying to figure out a world outside of it. And so, so that's why I'm looking at a co-liberation framework versus a solidarity framework, and seeking out my community partners in that way.